I'm gonna help you develop a strategy to put an offer on a property like this. Let's go check it out. Okay, so walking around the property, one of the best things that we saw was the panel box has been replaced. We noticed there's a brand new panel box. I don't even need to open it, but you can have an idea that you're gonna have new wiring through the property, maybe. But this is a good idea that they have done some work. But actually, it just kind of goes downhill from here on this one. And we'll walk around and I'll kind of give you the home inspector insight of the other things I saw. So the next stop is I noticed the gas meter's been removed. Gas meter could be removed for several reasons. The gas bill wasn't paid, that's normally the main reason. But the city could have found a gas leak somewhere in the structure, and that's the second reason. So you want to know if you've had prior gas problems. The next item is just by walking outside, I noticed the first pier is leaning out of place. With this first pier leaning out of place, you automatically know that you're gonna have some structural issues. And as we move further over, the next pier is out of place as well. And then moving even further over, you can see the patio leaning out of place. With all of this happening, you already know that you need a structural engineer or some sort of foundation company to come out to do some repair. With the recent flood in Harvey, a lot of the areas downtown, if you're starting to work on your foundation, you have to lift it up. One of the next obvious things that I noticed coming out on the structure was it was going to have termites. How I knew it was going to have termites is as I walked up to the structure, I saw the dry wood rot outside, and I noticed that there was ivy on the structure, heavy foliage, trees touching, and I knew the property has been sitting vacant for 6 months. Perfect condition for termites. I only had to look for about 5 minutes and I found them. Our next find, we have cast iron drain lines outside. With cast iron drain lines, it normally has about a 50-year lifespan. This property was built in 1940s, so I already know it's at the end of its life. We also noticed that there was galvanized water lines inside. Robert turned on the water for 1 minute and it was already leaking inside. So we know we have some major plumbing issues. And now let's go check out the next issue. Going back to the foundation on this property, we had dry wood rot on the exterior perimeter beam on the front side of the property, and I just touched it and it came off in my hand on the back side of the property. So we know that we have some major structural issues going from front to back now, and now our whole opinion has changed that you're going to even need more work on the foundation. Let's head to the backyard and find the next issue. Okay, so for the last thing in the backyard as we came around the corner, nothing really different, but I just give you another scenario of the perfect conditions for termites and things that are going to lead to the foundation movement. So you can see right here, the trees are touching the roof. You have poor drainage, which this is going to allow, it's going to allow more moisture over here, which invites termites and also foundation movement. You have dry wood rot too. So we have dry wood rot on the beam on the side and along the back. You're talking about maybe a full foundation replacement. Now let's head inside and finish the strategy on seeing if this is a house you want to put an offer in on. All right, so for another obvious find on this structure, the people before actually used wood in the bathroom. So now you're going into a whole nother realm of having to take care of this structure. Let's go in the kitchen and finish the final strategy of how to put in an offer on a home like this. All right, let's do a quick recap. We had several obvious signs of the structure. We had obvious foundation issues. We had obvious plumbing issues. We had drain line issues. Several things inviting termites, and we even found termites on the structure. Whenever you have this many things leading up to a overall assessment of if you want to put an offer on the structure, you even start to fall out of a realm of even needing a general trek inspection anymore or a home inspection. You actually want a general contractor and maybe even just a termite inspector. This general contractor can come in and actually give you a full assessment and the price it takes to fix this property. But a home inspector, he's just going to come in here and tell you everything's broken, which you probably already know. So if you have any home inspections questions, please give us a call and please like and share the videos. Thanks guys. Bye.
I'm preparing myself.
Alright, you ready? You ready to record that?